What's up, everybody? Henry from Fun Game Reviews Company, guys, to bring you a little bit more information to all you new players out there. Yes, I know for all you guys who are free-to-play players or pay-to-play players, even though you guys buy resources, you guys want to know exactly what you should be buying. So I'm going to start out with the new players, free-to-play players. And then for those of you guys who are pay-to-play players who definitely want to know how to maximize the most you want, most you can, let me know in the comments down below and I will definitely make a video specific to you guys. But this one's going to be directed to all free-to-play players and new players alike. Alright guys, as you guys know, I have made previous videos on how to earn the red gems, the blue gems, and how to maximize as much as possible. But this time, we're going to be talking about friendship points, where what are you going to actually be utilizing it for. A lot of you guys will probably be focusing on red star stones later down the line. Not now, at least when you reach level 120, then you guys can focus on leveling up your clan a lot more and start working on it a lot more. But obviously you guys get free equipment boxes every single day, 3 times a day. But for me, here is what I would say the best items are. If you are a non-PvP player, I would actually go for auto clear selection box. This thing lets you choose from Adina box, EXP, or the daily dungeons. As you guys know, you guys are going to need a lot of them anyways, like 4 if you guys can do very hard in daily dungeons, 4 if you can do the hard modes in Adina, 4 if you're going to do the hard in EXP, and then I think it's 3 for just like normal, and then it's I think it's 2 for the easies, okay? So other than that, I mean, that is it for friendship points. I know some of you guys who love PvP. I mean, this thing is good if you're not as active, okay? And you like to auto farm a lot and you're just trying to focus on leveling. Or do what I do. I basically buy these and save this for a good day. Where, like, if you're going on holiday or a vacation somewhere, and you don't, even though you're auto leveling like crazy, you don't have the time and effort to be able to put in that time to do that grind of all the different dailies that you have on Lineage 2. So, Cross of Repentance reduces a character's chaotic value. Each use reduces the chaotic value by 3, and use this effect 3 times a day. You can buy this 3 times a day, you can use this 3 times a day, but you can buy this 2 times a day. So for those of you guys who love PvP and you guys are trying to be the top clan out there who is known for murdering people, yeah, you guys who love to murder people. We all know we love killing everybody, PKing everybody, and harassing people who are all auto leveling. Yes, I know, we know who you are. All right. But yes, definitely Cross of Repentance is very, very useful. So these two are definitely the most useful. I mean, I know some of you guys who are thinking, oh, hey, let me save a little bit of money. Let me save a little bit of Dina. Buy the HP potion. This ain't worth it at all. Soul Shots, don't buy these 3. Completely useless. Completely useless. You can always farm enough Dina every day to get enough potions throughout the day. You're pretty much golden. All right, next on the list is the Clan Shop. Oh my god, yes, at level 9, we are basically unlocked on almost everything. At level 10, we will fully unlock the rest of it. I mean, for those of you guys who don't even know yet, I mean, 5 of Maverick's Protection Fragments, that is super important. You can actually also wait for the high-grade soul crystals. I mean, they are good, but they're a little pricey, and it's only 1. And you're only allowed to do it weekly. So it's not really that easy. And to actually farm these coins, you got to be doing the clan quest. You got to do a lot of them as much as possible to basically farm it out. But you guys can see at the level that we are at level 9, I basically take as many of these upgrade stones as possible. And then I go for enchantment scrolls so I can upgrade my weapons, my armor, my accessories. And then every day, oh my God, every day, please make sure you guys are grabbing the greater EXP. That thing gives me over 300,000 EXP. It is like one click, you got all the EXP. You don't even have to worry about dailies, weeklies, scroll quests, none of that stuff. You just handle that business. All right. And like I said, you can buy this daily, but it's not worth it. Auto clear selection box. I only do those just for like a good day. And right now, I'm currently getting the high grade varnish box because these are selection boxes. They actually allow you to choose weapon, armor, or accessories. Right now, I abuse this so that I can actually level up my weapons as much as possible to quickly get myself to SR weapons and max out the levels. I mean, you guys can also, if you guys have a lot of excess, you guys are like the top tier people who are doing so much, and you have so many coins to burn, you can go for the EXP too until you're level 120. Once you're level 120, this becomes completely useless until they raise the cap. Okay, and I know watching Korean versions, they raise the cap to 260, but that ain't gonna happen for quite some time, guys. Not for quite a while. But yeah, I mean, these are the key items I would definitely recommend buying every single time. The weeklies are the most important to buy because you can only get this 3 a week. Okay, enchantment scrolls the same, 3 a week. And these are weeklies. So the weeklies, these three are the main biggest items you definitely want to buy. And then like greater EXP is like one of the main things I buy. You can also buy the Cross of Repentance once again here, but I say it's more fun when you're level 120, you're PKing people. That's when it's definitely worth killing people because you're already capped out and you're like just finding other reasons to do different things in the game, like farming, codex, whatever. When you get bored, go murder people. Go murder people. That's what I like to do. I just go PK the hell out of everybody just because I feel like. All right. And then let's go check the last thing that I know is a huge question for a lot of different people. In the shop, it's the mastery shop. What the hell do you buy here? Because after level 31, you get one damn mastery coin every freaking level. I know you can, like, sometimes it can vary. You can get a little bit more coins here and there. But literally, you're getting one damn coin every single time. What is the most important thing that you can buy here that is definitely worth your mastery coins? Because eventually, you'll run to a point where you get no more mastery. Because mastery is only gained for every one level after level 31. Okay? So I'm gonna tell you. I basically take SPs. SP is probably the only thing that is like the w most worth it. Everything else is not worth it. And plus, it's like kind of the cheapest thing here. I mean, these two, obviously, you don't want to waste it on it. But SP, you don't really get too much skill points from anything. I mean, you can farm it every day. You can definitely farm it enough, but as you grow levels, you guys will definitely see that there's no way of ever capping out every single skill there is. I mean, once you cap out at level 120 and you do cap out your skills and you farm every day, you will continue to get those SPs. But at the same time, that's going to be a while until you fully cap everything out because you guys already know it ain't cheap. And this is only 10 SP. So, I mean, technically, from level 31 to level 120, that's about 89 points that you can actually earn. So, think about it, you can get additional 80, 80-ish of the SPs. I mean, it helps. It doesn't help that much, but it helps. Okay. So other than that, guys, that's pretty much it for all the stuff you should be buying on those three different markets to you maximize as much as possible. So make sure you guys are leaving me a like, subscribe, and share. And I hope to see you guys again. This is Henry from Fun Game Reviews. Much love and happy Lineage 2 gaming. Peace out.